Hey guys, and welcome back to another video. Today we want to talk about the world record which is just getting made basically. So we are talking about the most clam war wins in the entire world, and the clan which is achieving this is Helldrinkers. They're already the number one clan in the world when it comes down to war wins, but what they're doing as well, there will be the first clan ever who achieve 1,000 war wins, which is a crazy amount of wins. It's just consider this in time, like every war taking 48 hours and then obviously a couple of losses and everything. This is a crazy amount, and you can see in the background the time is ticking down, which means this will be the 1,000th war win of them. And thank you guys so much for inviting me over. We will obviously show you guys a couple of attacks of their war win, of their 1,000th war win. And this will be not only Town Hall 13, since they're a mixed clan, which means it's going to be Town Hall 11, 12, and Town Hall 13. So we will have a nice mix in this video, which I hope you guys will like. And we're waiting for the timer to run down, because this is a heroic moment. Like I said, this has never been done before. And just this amount of war wins, it's crazy to me. It's super, super crazy. A couple of more seconds, and then it's done. Then it should be in the profile of the clan, and we should be able to see it. This war is won, nearly the perfect war. I mean, it was close, nearly the perfect war. And now what I think what we should do, I think we should double check in the clan description. There you guys can see it, 1,000. This is nuts, this is crazy. So yeah, huge congrats obviously to the guys over there. Thank you guys so much for inviting me. But I think now this was a lot of talking. Now we're getting into the couple of attacks. So I have a couple of attacks which I want to show you guys. And obviously highlight and see whether I can explain a little bit more about what exactly are they using. One quick heads up, I think there are a couple of small lags in this video, apparently the gameplay. The reason for that was like my PC, which was stuttering a little bit. I hope I fix it for the next video, but for this one, it might be still there. So I'm super sorry for that, but let's get into the attack. The first attack is going to be a queen charge hybrid attack. They love this attack strategy. When I skipped through the attacks, which they did a lot of queen charge hybrid. So I like that they're using the more strategic strategies and not too much Yeti spam, which is so much out there, it's crazy. But they're more going into the like calculated attacks, which is queen charge minus, for example. So let's take a look how exactly he's doing. He's taking care of the single throne tower and the eagle early on with the Yeti blimp, luring out the clan castle. And now they have, well, he has a really nice path for his miners and hawk riders, obviously, for the town hall. Meanwhile, the queen is taking off both scattershots in the core, everything, which means crazy, crazy value. So he's starting, he's not deployed the king yet. And one thing which I like is that he's delaying the king for the storages. This is actually a really good thing. And when I watched the attack the first time, I was like, wait, where's the king? And when I rewatched the attack and I thought about it, this is way better, because what this does is, in the beginning, the path was already kind of narrow, which means the king was not really needed. And now he has like more power for the storages. So this was like a 1 million IQ move, really nicely done by him. And now he's pushing through the core, and you guys can see it. The healers are switching, which means obviously his queen is like a little bit weaker due to that. But the healers are always switching between of the miners and hawk riders back to the queen, back to the miners kind of, which is obviously really nice for him. So he has the queen ability, so he has the power left, which he needs to push to the last part of the base. He still has a free spell left, and this base is completely wrecked. And as you guys can see, there's a little bit of stuttering in the gameplay. I'm super sorry for that. But either way, this is completely wrecked of him. And this is going to be the first triple. Like I said, I wish you guys not only Tower 13, but as well Tower 12 and Tower 11, because that's like the main breakdowns which they're using. Not too many Tower 10s or 11s even. Tower 10s or 9s, I wanted to say, in there. So let's get into the next attack, which is going to be, let me double check, I think this one. Yep, here we go. And this is going to be a queen charge Lalo. I like that because, like I said, they're using a huge variety on different strategies. They're using basically everything, which I like a lot. So they're using queen charge hybrid the most, I think. But except that, they're using everything else as well. So for example, on this base, they like the idea of the queen charge Lalo. And I like the plan a lot. So when I first saw this attack, I was like, okay, what is happening to this scatter shot? Because nothing can reach that. And then I watched the attack, and actually what he did was really, really clever. So what he decided was that he is going for the scatter shot with the Royal Champ. Because as you guys know, in the Queen Charge Lano, the Royal Champ most of the time it's not needed that like that badly, especially if you can take out the enemy queen and the enemy royal champion. The royal champ is more like taken out for, or is like used for creating pathing, taking care of certain defenses which your queen might not be able to reach. And this is the perfect example. Lalo's getting started from the top. Tauros not getting not taken down yet. But either way, the Lalo's coming in. Queen is doing her thing. And now she's getting rotated into the Tauros, which she's supposed to take out as well, because she can reach it, which is nice. And now warden ability on basically everything. So the warden ability was OP. And what he's doing now, I don't know if I would have done the same. But he's using the slammer for the back and Inferno Tower. I think I would have used it on the right side to like more like support the Lalo part. Because now the Mutant Inferno Tower on the right side keeps staying, and this keeps like creating like a backtracking of the loons, kinda. But either way, I mean, you guys saw already, this is gonna be a triple. So I mean, whoever is tripling is right, right? So this is how we do it. And yeah, the haste spell is leading all of the last, all of the couple of loons there into the last Archer Tower. And this means this is going to be a nice 3-star of him. Well done, sir. And this means we're done with the Tower 13 attacks, which means we're switching now over to the Tower 12 attacks. I think I had one fail in there, because like you guys will see this kind of quickly, but since I'm only playing Tower 13 at the moment, I was not really paying attention. But I think this is actually a dip, right? So, oh no, this is not the dip. I think, no, this should not be the dip. I don't know. I think I will show you guys in a second a dip or something. We will double check. So for now, we will take a look at this attack. And I have to say, I don't really like the funnel in the beginning. I have to say, I'm not a huge fan of E-Drag funneling. I feel like there are most of the time other safer options. And for example, cheaper options. So like Baby Dragon, a couple of loons and stuff like that. So for example, you would have had most likely the same value with like 5 troop space less, and without having the risk of over there being a black mine. For example, 1 Coco Loon, 1 Baby Dragon, 1 Loon would have completely done the same without having the risk of the Electro Dragon running into a black mine. That's just a small thing of mine, and now all of the troops are spreading around, and the enemy clan castle is coming out, but the ram is kind of the key thing in this attack, and I feel like I see this really rarely on Tower 13. But on Tower 12 and Tower 11, for example, it's getting more and more it's still popular to use the ram kind of often, especially in those big pushes with the Yeti smash or Pekka smash or Pekka Bobat and stuff like that. So on this one, it was a really nice plan with having the bats now on the right side for the expos. And even though the attack is like slowly but surely getting like destroyed, or like the troops are getting destroyed, but his queen is always staying alive, and this is kind of the key in this attack, which makes sure that this is going to be a triple in the end. And once again, guys, I'm super sorry for the stuttering. I don't know. Like I said, I fixed it for the next couple of videos, but in this one, it's still in there. I'm sorry. But yeah, now take a look at those air skeletons, at this freaking air skeleton army. This is nuts. So yeah, queen is, like I said, still staying alive. At the bottom there are a couple of more wizards, and now you can see only the queen is basically alive and will clean up this entire attack. So nicely done by him. And even though this was more like one more of those spammy type attacks, it's still a triple, and this is what matters in the end, getting the triple down so you can win the entire war. So nicely done by him. So let's get into the next attack. Like I said, I think the next one is going to be, let me double check, yeah, this was, I don't know why I didn't saw it, but this was actually a dip. I will notice it in a second. But, well, I'm not too good at seeing hero levels and everything. So, yeah, I noticed it was a dip. So let's jump into the Tower 11 attack, because, like I said, we have still a Tower 11 attack to go. So only one Tower 12 attack. I hope you guys do not mind. And this is going to be the Tower 11 attack. And I think this is actually one of my bases which I posted, like, years back. I think it was one of the ETH bases, like a Liveron original. So it's kind of funny seeing the base now. And what this guy is doing, he's throwing the kind of kill squad Hawk Rider at this base. And one thing which I'm always surprised when seeing those attacks, it's like, dude, why are you using the Warden for the push? Like, how do you want to get rid of the Giga Bomb on the Town Hall? Then I remember, like, oh yeah, that's Town 11, like where the Town Hall is completely useless. And it's always kind of funny when you're playing only one Town 11, then it's like watching another Town 11, you're super surprised about a couple of things. either way, what this guy did, he's using the Hog Riders, or like the mass Hog Riders, after his main push in there. He used a couple of bolus in his ramp, which is always nice, especially if you have the Warden ability with you and the Rage spell. Like, those bolus do work. It's crazy. And now the Hog Riders going through the back end of this base, slowly but surely dying out around the bomb tower because of the King. But in the main, or like in the middle, there are still a couple of Hog Riders left. He has still tons of heal spells left, but slowly but surely, like I said, the Hog Riders are dying out, and the last heal was, I think, a bit too late. You could have used it a bit earlier. Only a couple of Hog Riders still left. He's using the last heal spell, but like I said, once again, the heroes are clutch. And this is one reason why I think you guys should make sure to upgrade your heroes. Because, obviously, you can always rush the tower levels, but believe me, it won't be any fun for you guys if you have rushed heroes on a really high tower level. It's not fun. The heroes are the key for your attacks, and I know it's freaking annoying because they take so long to upgrade, but it's worth it. Like, as soon as you have your heroes well upgraded, the game is like double as fun. So yeah, either way, this is going to be the triple, and this is going to be the end of the video. I hope you guys liked it. Let me guys know how many war wins you guys have right now. And yeah, this is just a crazy achievement. 1,000 war wins. Warwinds, the number one clan, and the number one clan who was able to reach 1,000. So, huge congrats to them. Thank you so much for having me, and I hope you guys liked today's video. See you guys back tomorrow. Until then, bye-bye.